I wanted to do this cold cut today on hatred towards your brother, because a lot of camps be getting a lot of slack from different camps, and arguing and strife and contention been going on amongst Israel. And we too far in the game to be dealing with foolish stuff like this.
Revelation chapter 13, 16 through 18.
He went over the soul.
Rich and poor.
He went over the soul.
Rich and poor.
He went over the soul.
Rich and poor.
A lot of camps be getting a lot of slack from different camps, and arguing and strife and contention been going on amongst Israel. You sowing discord among brethren. Brothers that who is at peace with you, you sowing discord with them? The Lord hates that. The Lord is offended at your soul, man. With you acting like that, what are you doing bringing false witnesses? Like, oh yeah, I can tell these brothers is proud. So we can't raise up a false report like, oh, these brothers don't believe that the mark of the beast is a chip. They set up by Esau, that's why they got so many views. That's raising a false report. That's raising that's slandering your brother's name. You're not doing that to edify anybody. You're doing that to make your views go up, because you're going to use a platform for somebody else, and you bringing your brother down. The Lord requires that of the past. So it's going to happen again. It's happening again, man. Y'all being niggas, man. Be kings, man. Kings don't sit there and argue with one another. Kings don't sit there and argue with one another. Kings don't sit there and argue with one another. Kings don't sit there and argue with one another. How to deal with elders. This information is not to be wasted casually for unprofitable and carnal debate. We're not supposed to be up here debating one another and arguing with one another about small topics of the matter, when all we need to really agree on is keeping the faith, law, statutes, and commandments. That's all we need to agree on. 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 If you want to push a doctrine that you feel is right in your heart, push that doctrine. If you want to push a doctrine that you feel is right in your heart, push that doctrine. If you want to push a doctrine that you feel is right in your heart, push that doctrine.
If you want to push a doctrine that you feel is right in your heart, push that doctrine. Push that doctrine. Push that doctrine. Push that doctrine.
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh. Bahashem Yahawashah, Bahashem Racha Hakadosh, and double honors to the apostles and the elders, the Zequamium of Great Millstone. Also, I'm going to give a shalom to the elect that's laboring. And I want to touch on another video with these guys, the Adam Abbotts, the Adam Abbott group. You know, what can we say? You know, I mean, we go back and forth with these guys, and it's not really worth doing a million videos on them, but, you know, I will do it in the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah to keep fighting for the truth, contending for the truth. They go on to say we teach hate, but you should see the comments that I get. If that ain't hate, what is? But anyway, hypocrites. Anyway, I went on his channel. The brother from my camp sent me the video, and this is what I look at, you know, these videos like this, to defend the truth. Okay? These guys are already known as a form of reprobates. Okay? I mean, they're still pushing, and they do bring out the precepts and push the scriptures, but that ain't gonna cut it. It's more to it than that. Anyway, this video, this comment, her name is Yapah M. Styles. See, we can see, and I don't know what it is with this younger generation and these, you know, if the women, maybe this is just another way to pick up women. I don't know. In my days, I was, you know, on the basketball court, and, you know, going to the malls. You know, you do your thing, but these days, it's a different genre. It's a different area. So you gotta understand it, but when it comes to the truth, the world is supposed to be separate. okay, from the truth. Okay, so all the women on the social media, it's just a, they're social media nuts. This is all it is, man. Anyway, it says, I think this video will still go over a lot of Israel's heads, still want to debate, still want to argue, still have hatred and strife. Pray for Israel. We're in the last days, need and need the Most High to hate the enemy. Okay, let's go. You know, a word came to my mind, you know, to my visuals that she said, and it says, and why even entertain the thought of a woman on the keyboard? But this is the argument that all these men have, because the men is the one that, you know, that lay out the red carpet for these women. Okay, that's what you men do, man. You're simps. That's what you are, man. And I'm gonna call it like it is. You're simps. Anyway, Jude 1:3. It says, "Beloved, when I gave all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation, it was needful for me to write unto you and exhort you that ye should earnestly contend for the faith." I don't see S on the end of that word. Not faith, but faith, which was once delivered unto the saints. Okay? The elect. Okay? Not everybody. So, this is disturbing of how this Jake, who claims that we all brothers, we're brother, you know, we're Israelites, you know, but we're not brothers in the spirit. Okay? So, it's disturbing how he says, don't matter what doctrine you have, just push it. But I don't see here where it says you can push many doctrines. I know the scripture says every man has a song, and I mean a doctrine and a different way of, you know, in the scriptures, different gifts basically. You know, one brother good in understanding the precepts, another brother's good at understanding the Hebrew, another brother's good at with different languages. But come on, man. Okay? The scriptures clearly say, let all things be done decently in order. And the Lord is not an author of confusion. So in that confusion, if you could just push many doctrines. So we're supposed to contend for the faith. There's only one doctrine we're supposed to contend for. So let's go to this word contend. Okay? Let's look up this word. The word contend means to strive via a contest. Uh-oh. Or rivalry, or against difficulties, to struggle. Goes on to say to strive in debate, to argue, fight. We're supposed to argue for this truth. So when you go to the red letter Bible, you know, these people just think Yahweh Shah just came on the scene. He went to the Israelites. I'm not sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Okay, the lost sheep, the elect, okay? Not Esau. Why go out and try to spread? And this is the problem I'm having. You guys, you don't hold accountability to your women or your keyboard scoffers or your keyboard haters. And when you did the video on the confusion of faith, all these people that claimed they loved you, they was the main ones talking shit on you. How you let that Edomite slide in. You know, just the wickedest stuff. These people do not care about the truth. They care about some new form of entertainment. They've done away with the VHF and the UHF and came in with cable, and now they done took it to another level. Now they're using the airwaves, okay? Now they're using digital frequency technology. The very technology is going to be the end of this destruction of this world, man. And you guys have a problem with us teaching the RFID. Everything was fine when you stayed in your lane. But when you came out of your lane, something happened. And what I mean by that, pushing a false doctrine. Matthew 5:17 says, if anyone breaks the least of these commandments and shall teach men so, okay? This false Sabbath day you're teaching. Where's Phrius and Saturn in the Bible, man? Where's the goddess Phrius and Saturn in the Bible? Anyway, let's go on to Isaiah 8:21. 8:21. to the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. This word. So the Lord, Jeremiah 17:4, and I'll quote some precepts because I do that a lot, says we would discontinue from our heritage, right? So if we could discontinue from our heritage and the Lord has given it back to us, hey man, the Lord just didn't beam down here with some book and assemble 500 people and gave it all to them and that's it. The Lord set up elders, okay, to teach and give it to you to get, basically to reach the elect, okay? Who knows who the elect is, but that's how the Lord set it up. The Lord just didn't set it up, okay, and if that's the case, you wouldn't have all these different groups, would you? The Lord set the Lord allowed this to happen so we can contend each with each other for the faith. That's how the Lord works, man. Y'all think that the all of Israel supposed to be together. Y'all know the precepts. Man's goings are of the Lord. How then can a man understand his own way? Y'all know that. So isn't it us too? Isn't it all of us camps too? Come on, man. Y'all spit out scriptures and you don't understand what you're spitting out. Secondly, let's read another scripture. This is ridiculous. Romans 16:17, it says, now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions. Divisions mean different doctrines and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. Well, hold on. This message is only going for the Israelites, and y'all all know this. So why would this scripture be here? The so-called white man doesn't have this doctrine. He doesn't claim he's an Israelite. This is talking about Israelite groups, okay? And the elect is supposed to mark these groups or anybody, even in, it don't have to be Great Millstone, just in general, that's going off on doctrine, okay? Let me read it again to get it through your head, man. Now I beseech you, brethren, talking about the brethren. You guys can't be our brother. Not saying that the mark of the beast is not the microchip. You can't be our brother, because whoever accepts that chip is going to die, okay? It's going to catch famine and be destroyed. But either that or nuclear missiles. Mark them. Who's the them? The white man? No, these are talking about Israelites. Which cause divisions and offenses contrary to doctrine, okay? Which ye have learned, and avoid them, okay? So what it means by saying mark them? Uh-oh, that's another mark. Y'all think that's... Now that's not the mark of the beast. We understand that. That's talking about another mark. But you guys don't understand even the English language. You guys are supposed to be educated. You're supposed to understand the homophones, man. You're supposed to understand that words spell the same and they have different meanings. Like the word lie, when you lie on someone, okay? Or like you lie on a doctrine. Or lie when you lie down. They spell the same, but they have different meanings. You guys supposed to be educated and know that. So why wouldn't that be the case in the scriptures with the word mark? In this scripture, the word mark in Ezekiel the 9th chapter, and the word mark, which is separate, and that's why it's in Revelations, because you had a problem and said it wasn't in the Old Testament, because that mark is a definite different mark than the other marks that you see. That's why. Okay, anyway, one of these, again, you have these haters. You know, and they claim we can't bang. The one guy said, I don't know who the hell he is. He sounded like he had some lust towards one of the so-called brothers, Naquam or whatever. He just flies into the rescue. It's like he got something, some type of fetish. It's like he got some type of fetish with that guy, man. I don't understand it, man. You know? And this guy don't even know the scriptures. Okay, this scoffer that doesn't even know the scriptures, but I'm not going to say your name because it's not even worth it. You know, it claims that we can't bang, we hate our brother, we can't bang. We're not camp banging, man, we're doctrine banging. Okay, get that straight. It had nothing to do with camps, man. This is a doctrine bang. We're fighting for the doctrine, and you guys say just like the Bloods and the Crips. Well, you're damn right. We have nothing to do with Bloods and Crips, with any associated with any kind of worldly gang, but this is a spiritual somewhat gang, if you want to call it that. This is a spiritual fight, man. Okay? That's right, territories of doctrines. So you got the Satan work on the left-hand side, and you got the Lord that does it on the right-hand side. Okay? The scripture says, hate the evil, okay, and love the good. That RFID chip is evil, and you guys are not hating it. Okay? So you claim we hate our brothers. No, we hate what you stand for, man. We hate what you stand for. Okay? And the guy in the clip said we need to warn the people. We need to warn the people. What the hell you think we're doing? You guys aren't. Even if you felt this wasn't the mark of the beast, why aren't you warning them and saying not to take something like that and it's wicked? Okay? You know, you the guys are the go-along, get-along guy prophets, man. You know, that's all you are, man. You guys are the go-along, get-along prophets. Okay? Let's get John. Let's get John 7:18. It says, he that speaketh of himself seeketh his own glory. Okay? And that's what you guys do, man. You're all about yourself. You're seeking your own glory, man. Okay? We're trying to seek the elect. You guys are just social media nuts. That's all you are, man. And everybody falls for it. They love it. They love the entertainment. Cutting the white man. And some of them people you claim you're cutting may not even be the so-called white man. They could be Israelites. And some of them people you claim, sister, come back. Sister, we love you, sister. Brother, we're trying to teach you. And he not getting it because he could be an Edomite. He could be a heathen. You guys need to step up your game, man. See, the only way you can get that social media rev going on if you always have some form of competition. And like boxing, sports, and any other entertainment, that's what Jake loves. That's why he sits back on Xbox Live and play video games, okay? That's why after school, Jake will stand around and watch a fight, okay? That's why when somebody gets robbed, Jake will sit up there and stand back and watch the robbery happen and don't know shit. Okay, this is Matthew 12:50. It says, for whosoever shall do the will of my Father, which is in heaven, the same is my brother and my sister and my mother. So you should get the point. Are you guys doing the will of the Heavenly Father? Do you think going out teaching that the white man is the devil, okay, and that we're Israelites, that is the will of the Heavenly Father. But when you teaching that the RFID is not the microchip, you just cut it. You're not doing the will of the Heavenly Father, okay? And you know what? If you don't want to believe it, you don't have to believe it. But you're so goddamn proud that you had to just step up there and cross the line, man, okay? Because you're prideful. We don't care about views. See, we heard this nutcase talk about the views. It's a cry because you want more views. One guy asked me, one of the scoffers said, well, you don't have no subscribers, and I didn't even know how many subscribers I had. I don't look at that. See, only a video nutcase that wants entertainment, that wants some form of fame, will look at the views and look at the subscribers. The Lord is dealing with a small number. If you leave it up to you guys, every Israelite will wake up, it'll be 250,000 prophets. And the scripture says 144,000. But up to you guys, it'll be 250,000 so-called Negroes. That's all I have on that. Shalom.